Hi, welcome back. I'm Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about P, NP, NP hard and NP complete problem. Before we start, just one small request. If you are a new visitor, kindly subscribe it and press the bell icon so that you will get all the updates from this channel. So let us start. Basically, any problem is given. To find the solution, we write an algorithm. And the algorithm can be solved either in polynomial time or in a non-polynomial time. That we already know. Now let us see what is a P-class problem. P-class problems are those problems which can be solved by polynomial time. For example, if you say the sorting and searching algorithms are polynomial time. Why? You can say if you take a searching algorithm, if you take linear search, the complexity is order of n, big O of n. And if you are searching using binary search, it can be log base to n. Similarly, for sorting also, we can sort a set of data in a polynomial time. Now let us see what is NP class problem. NP class problem are those problems which cannot be solved using polynomial time but can be verified in polynomial time. For example, if you are having a Sudoku problem, prime factor problem, scheduling problem, traveling salesman problem, all these problems are examples. There are many more in this class. You might have realized the polynomial time with sorting and searching, but I'm going to give you an example of Sudoku right now. How that I can say that this is an NP class problem? Let us see. So let us say this is a Sudoku. It means in all the boxes, we have to fill the data from 0 to 9. In all the rows, the data must be 0 to 9. In all the columns, the data must be 0 to 9. And none of other places, numbers will be repeated. Let us try to solve the first three cluster matrix. So 1, 2, 4 and 7 are missing in this first block. Let us try to fill the first empty square. I can fill it with out of the 4 in one way. It means 4 possibilities are there to fill one square. For the next square, there will be 3 possibilities. For the next square, I'll be having 2 possibilities. And for the last square, I'll be having only one possibility. It means 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. To fill this 3 cross 3 matrix, I'll be having 4 factorial ways I can fill it. There are 9 such matrices are there. And in each of the matrix, number of unknowns are not fixed. Here there are 4 unknowns. Here there are 5 unknowns. Here there are 8 unknowns. That I have to fill. Along with that, I have to check in the first row how many unknowns are there. It must suit or it must fit in such a way that whatever value I'll keep it here, that value should not appear in this column or in this square. So it is very, very difficult. It will take exponential time to solve this problem. If somebody has solved the problem and told me that I have the solution for this Sudoku, then I can very well verify in this square 1 to 9 is there or not. In this row, is there any repetition? In this column, is there any repetition? So I can very well check or I can very well verify that this Sudoku is properly done or not. That is why we are saying solving the problem is difficult, but verifying is easy. So such kind of problem, I'll say, is a NP class problem. Hope you understood now. Now, the NP class problem, as we already discussed, verification is very easy. Verification takes polynomial time. It means what? It is hard to solve, easy to verify, and it takes exponential time. So I can say, let us say, a set we are saying that whatever comes under this set is of NP class. Okay. Now let us talk about P class problem. We know that not only we can solve it in polynomial time, but we can verify it also in polynomial time. If a data is given to sort, then not only I can sort it in polynomial time, But if a sorted data is there, I can verify whether the data is properly sorted or not, also in polynomial time. Okay, so P class problem will be solved in polynomial time as well as verified in polynomial time. So it is easy to solve, it is easy to verify, and it takes polynomial time. So obviously P class problem is inside the NP class problem. NP class problem takes those problems which are difficult to solve, easy to verify. P class problem takes those problems which are easy to solve and easy to verify. Then I can say P is a subset of NP. Along with that, those problems which comes under P is called tractable problem, and those problems which comes under NP are called intractable problems. It is a $1 million question. Till now nobody has solved it. Is P equal to NP? Now we'll see, before trying or before thinking about P equal to NP or not, what are the implications? If somebody proves that P is equal to NP, then what will happen? If somebody can prove that problem P are equal to NP, information security or online security are really, really vulnerable to attack. And everything becomes much more efficient, such as transportation problems, scheduling problem, understanding your DNA, all these things becomes easy to understand. At the same time, your security becomes very, very vulnerable, because all the security algorithms comes under NP. Difficult to find a solution, but if a solution is there, it is easy to verify it. But if those security problems becomes P problems, means easy to solve and easy to verify, then obviously the information securities are vulnerable to attacks. Okay, on the other way, if somebody proves P is not equal to NP, and then you can boldly say there are some problems that cannot be solved. It is also a very big challenge to say there are problems which cannot be solved. Now let us see what is reduction. Let us say a problem A is given to me, and I can convert it to problem B. And this reduction from problem A to problem B supposed to take a polynomial time. It means I can say let A and B are two polynomials, then problem A reduces to problem B if and only if there is a way to solve A by deterministic algorithm that solve B in polynomial time. If I want to show that A can be solved in polynomial time, then I don't know yet, but I know that B can be solved in polynomial time. Then what I'll do, I'll reduce A to B and I'll solve B. And after solving B, as B can be solved in polynomial time, I can say A is also in polynomial time problem. So if A is reducible to B, then it is written as A is proportionate to B. Now let us see the properties of reduction. If A is reducible to B and B is in P, is a polynomial time I can solve, then I can say A is also can be solved in polynomial time. The second property is, if A is not in P, then it implies B is also not in P. We are going to use these properties in the next videos to come. Now let us see what is NP hard problem. So a problem is NP hard if every problem of NP can be polynomially reduced to it. Let us see diagrammatically. So these are my NP problem, and if I'm having a set, then all the problems of NP can be reduced to this particular set, and the reduction will take polynomial time, then I'll say this set is NP hard. Now let us see what is NP complete problem. The definition is, the problem is NP complete if it is in NP and it is NP hard. It means we are going to reduce it. We are using reduction formula. Let us see, Here is the NP problem and here is the reduction problem. So NP is reduced to NP hard. This part is NP hard. Again, to which part of this NP hard problem? Those are in NP. So if we are reducing this NP problem to this particular part, then and this particular part belongs to NP. And this reduction will take polynomial time. This red part will say is a NP complete problem. It means what? The class of NP complete problem is an intersection of NP and NP hard class of problem. So we know that the intersection part is NP complete and this part is NP hard. Then NP complete problem are basically are the decision problems, and the NP hard problems are basically are the optimization problem. If a problem A is a decision problem, it means it is an NP complete problem, then we can convert this problem to optimization problem, that is a NP hard problem. For example, a knapsack decision problem can be converted to knapsack optimization problem. So I can say decision problems can be converted to a optimization problem. All the NP complete problem are NP hard, but all the NP hard problems are not NP complete. That is evident from this particular diagram, because the intersection part only comes under NP complete. There is a large portion which comes under NP hard. All the portion of NP hard doesn't comes under this intersection. So that's why NP complete problems can be NP hard, but all the NP hard problems cannot be NP complete. So what we learn when we are talking about computational complexity problem, we can divide the problem into either P class or NP class. Again, NP class problem can be either NP hard or NP complete. So in our next video, we are going to discuss about different theorem proving using this NP hard, NP complete, P and NP set of problems. So keep watching, keep learning. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Please share this video with your friends.